ASMR world.
Today,
we're going to be discussing WWE or World Wrestling Entertainment, or as I like to call it, I'd actually got a word for it, at times World's Worst Entertainment. Zayn came out, didn't he? Pulled KO off the table. Shane went straight through it. KO won the match. That was, what, about a year ago, give or take. I'm not sure of the date. And now we're getting KO. He came back as a heel. Well, he came back as a babyface, didn't he? A heel, pretend to be a babyface. He had his little bit with Kofi, where he pretended to join the New Day, then turned on Kofi. They had a match or two, and as it, KO's babyface run was pretty much, heel run was done again. Don't get me wrong, I like LCBA. Sorry, the dog's in here. I do like this KO, the one who's telling people how it is. Look, Shane, people don't like you. You're taking time away from Buddy Murphy, from Apollo Crews, you know, TV time. The same time, do we need KO as a babyface again already? So he obviously stunned Shane McMahon twice, I believe, on Tuesday, beginning of the show, when he was in the ring, and beginning of the show and the end of the show, when he had a match against Dolph Ziggler, and all the lumberjacks came down, surrounded the ring, yet KO stunned Shane and still got away. He's a bit, like I said, rinse and repeat. And this is, once again, Shane McMahon in a major storyline again. He's just had one with that's completely blank, guys. A proper blank. But basically, he's been having himself a fair few major fights, hasn't he, recently? Shane McMahon. Who is he taking on? In recent memory, he's had a feud with AJ Styles. He's had a feud with... Oh, bloody hell. Literally, he was about to come to me just then. Anyway, Roman Reigns, he's had one with recently. He's just had a tag team match against The Undertaker, which was just so random, it wasn't even funny. And now, he is getting into another feud with KO. One of the main storylines on SmackDown involves Shane McMahon again. And it's just a little bit frustrating for me to sit back and watch, because, alright, they're trying to say, look, we acknowledge the fans believe Shane is getting too much time, but in giving us this storyline, what are you doing, or what are they doing? They're giving us more Shane McMahon. We are saying we don't want so much of him. They're saying, okay, we'll give you a storyline about it, which involves more Shane McMahon. Makes no sense. Nakamura is the new IC champion. Why, may I ask? He's been US champion previously, hasn't he? Didn't do anything with it. He's been the WWE champion. Didn't do anything with it. Do I think he'll do anything with the IC title? Nope. He was nowhere to be seen before that match. It was such a random match. Right, okay. Finn Balor has nothing at all to do. We've done nothing with him whilst he's had the title. That I know. Let's put him in there with Nakamura. What a great idea. The IC title, the US title, the women's tag titles, the which other titles? The Raw tag team titles, pretty much. The Universal title. Literally none of them mean anything right now. Even the women's title on Bayley means nothing at all right now, because the storylines mean nothing. The IC title. Nakamura's new champion after beating Finn Balor. Balor finally got himself a title and had no push at all. Like, I think that was his first title win when he won the IC title since he held the Universal title and had to give it up due to his injury caused by Seth Rollins when Seth threw him into that barricade, finned on his shoulder, had to give up the Universal title. And I believe the IC title's the first one he's won since then. And even then he wasn't given a push. So do I think Nakamura will be given any kind of storyline? Not really. Nothing decent anyway. Drew McIntyre loses for the third pay-per-view. I don't think that's in a row, but in like the last four or five, two losses to Roman, one at WrestleMania, one at Stomping Grounds. And he lost again at Extreme Rules in the tag match, again, against Roman and The Undertaker, with Shane McMahon as his partner. What the hell? I believed when Drew first came up and he was with Dolph Ziggler, okay, they're going to use Dolph to get him steadied on their main roster, get the fans sort of knowing who he is. They'll turn on Dolph, which is what happened. And then I thought he'd go after a title and win a title. He's been a bit sidetracked in the last 6 months, I'd say, since leaving Ziggler. Am I bothered? Not particularly. Do I really like Drew McIntyre? Not really. I believe he's a bit like a robot. Same old moves. Claymore kick, clotheslines, same old crap, different day. His style really does not entertain me. His promos drone on and on and on with that annoying bloody accent. Not against Scottish people, but just Drew McIntyre just irritates the crap out of me. And in all honesty, his hair and his tash are just a bit too black. It's a bit too... I could died. So I'm not gutted myself that Drew is losing. chased after Elias, beating up Elias. He had Drew McIntyre, same old crap. He had Bobby Lashley. He had all three of them at one time. He had Brock Lesnar, obviously. We had Baron Corbin as well. And Baron Corbin obviously hit Braun over the head with a briefcase when he was a special ref for the match against Brock Lesnar. And that eventually cost Brock the match. Braun the match very early on. But what is there for Braun? What's there left for him to do? I don't personally know. I mean, you put him in there against a smaller guy, he'll have a great match. Of course he will. But ultimately, the smaller guy is 9 times out of 10 going to lose. So it's great having a big man for Braun to go against, but you're running out of them. There are only 2 left off the top of my head on the main roster that I could see him up against. But one's now dropped out down to NXT, and one has gone off injured for quite a long time. Injured star is obviously Lars Sullivan. Finally got brought up, hell of a lot of promos, got his chance, put him in against Luke House Pie for about a month, gets injured, could be out for up to a year, I believe. NXT star is Killian Dane, he's come back down there. I've not watched NXT this week, but apparently he attacked Matt Riddle. That Killian Dane, I could see up against Braun Strowman, and I think that'd be a great match. In NXT now. The only other person on the main roster I'd like to see him against, as it is right now, would be the new Bray Wyatt. I think that'd be pretty cool. We saw Bray finally return to Raw on Monday when he attacked Finn Balor after Balor lost to Samoa Joe, wasn't it? I mean, you could have Joe against Braun, but again, Joe is being underused right now, big time. So I'd go with Bray Wyatt as of right now, because, as I said, Lars is injured and Killian Dane is down in NXT now. What else have we got here? Ricochet's push, is he already done? I know he's obviously in this feud right now with AJ. Ricochet had the US title. Now he doesn't. They've got the club back together. How long's that going to last? I'd say about a month at best. Is it very believable? Anderson and Gallows did their whole doctor buddy shit backstage. And now we're meant to believe that, Anderson and Gallows mean something all of a sudden. No, we have seen this happen before when they first came to WWE. AJ turned on, bloody hell, it wasn't Daniel Bryan, was it? When they first came up, I can't remember who he turned on now, but it happened anyway, didn't it? And he joined up with Anderson and Gallows. It lasted about a month then, and then it was just done, and I expect the same now. I put Ricochet. He was having a nice little push. They had no need at all to set the title off him. I do believe he'll get it back off AJ at some point. But you didn't need a title to make this match important. You don't need to play hot potato with a US title. It makes it less important. Apollo EC3. Oh, sorry. I've got a list here of some of the people we don't see anything of due to the fact that Shane is being given such a push. I've already gone over the Shane McMahon issue that I have with him taking too much time. But when you look at the names who aren't being used, Apollo Crews got like a 2-minute match the other day against somebody I can't remember who it was against now. EC3, Matt Hardy, AOP, they're back. Did you know they are back on Raw? You may have seen them come down during the on SmackDown rather, against the match between Dolph and KO. AOP came out. Andrade, hardly used right now. Has anyone even seen the matches he was having in 205 or on the pay-per-view pre-shows before being moved onto the main roster? Killian Dane is now back in NXT. Why? How the hell can you not use Killian Dane on the main roster? I don't know. Or even Sanity when they were together. Rusev, where is he? We've not seen anything of Rusev in about 3 months now. And Sheamus, they split up the bar. Cesaro gets a push. He's getting a big push at the minute. Those mic skills are terrible on his own. Sheamus is long gone right now. Whether or not he's asked for time off because of all the stuff he did with the bar, he wants a break, or they've just got nothing for him, I'm not sure. Roman Reigns and Shane McMahon, is it now done? I hope to God it is. Roman obviously beat Shane and Drew with The Undertaker as his partner. We got the whole crap about The Undertaker passing the torch by putting his hand on the Roman's shoulders and say, look people, I trust Roman. You need to trust Roman. Nobody trusts Roman Reigns to push Brit to take the company on to the next level. No one at all. Not even Vince, I don't believe. He wants to believe it, but he knows it won't happen. The fans just won't take to Roman. And obviously Shane's now in a feud with KO. So I do believe Roman's feud with Shane is done. Who next for Roman Reigns? Again, maybe Bray Wyatt. But Roman has to go over, so you don't want Bray Wyatt and his character being squashed so early on. I do believe that we will get Finn Balor and Bray Wyatt. Demon versus Bray is like psycho. I thought I'd write that down, obviously not. But yeah, I do believe that's what we'll see. Demon Balor against Bray Wyatt. Probably at SummerSlam. But Demon Balor has to lose. Because you can't give Bray all these promos and then have him get no push at all. Brock is the Universal Champion once again. Is this a good thing or a bad thing? Well, I gotta be honest, I was going to sleep watching Seth Rollins and his promos. I was literally sitting here. At least Paul Heyman put some life into the ring when he's doing a promo for Brock. Seth and Becky, I mean, it was like the Posh and Becks of the 90s at Man United. He was just getting a bit bloody sickly, if you ask me. And Baron Corbin against Seth was not doing anything for me either. But who is Brock's next opponent going to be? Well, we already know. It is Seth Rollins. Wow. More boring promos from Seth. About being the Beast Slayer. Absolute waffle. Waffle. More like the Beast's bitch. He should get that on his shirt. The Beast's bitch. After getting took out the other day so easily. Cesaro loses for the second time to Aleister Black on SmackDown. He demanded a rematch after Extreme Rules. He lost again to fade to Black. You know the kick. It's a great kick, but we didn't need to see Cesaro lose again. We need to see him getting a push. He lost on Raw in that it was part of that Battle Royal, wasn't he, I believe. Or maybe I'm wrong on that. No, I think I'm right in thinking that. And then he's just lost to Aleister Black. The second time in like 3 nights. I would have liked to have seen a best of five, the kind that we had, which gives Cesaro his push and put him with Sheamus in the first place. Sheamus and Cesaro hated each other back then, apparently, storyline wise. They had a match, they had a best of five, which I believe Cesaro eventually won, and eventually they were put together as a tag team and went on to do great things. Cesaro, Aleister Black, I think would have been great as a best of five series. With Black going out 3-2 on top in the end. And lastly is Kofi Kingston. Now, I've just literally mentioned this other bloke about 3 times with different feuds. But I would like to have seen it with Kofi, okay? Kofi's taken on AJ. He's taken on Daniel Bryan. He's taken on Samoa Joe. He's taken everyone on. Kofi Kingston has. And come through them all. I mean, who's left on SmackDown right now? Who is left that's believable? I'll give you the answer to that. Nobody. There's no one believable. I mean, didn't he have a match with Randy Orton as well for the title? I believe so. I could be wrong. KO, he had a feud with Kevin Owens. He's come through them all. Kofi has. And I would, if this man hadn't been took back down to NXT, I would have liked to have seen Killian Dane, Kofi Kingston. Okay, Kofi'd still come out on top. But it'd be a believable big man for him to take on. I just don't see where the storyline goes with Kofi. Who could you have taken off him now? Who would be believable? I'd like to see Sami Zayn, Kofi Kingston. I think that'd be a great feud. I think they'd do fantastic things. We've just seen Dolph Ziggler against Kofi recently. He's had Joe, Kofi, Joe, Dolph, AJ. So you've got the title off, wasn't it? Oh, no, it's Daniel Bryan took the title off. He had a match with... Did he have a match with Brock? I don't know if he didn't, did he? That was Daniel Bryan was the last one to have a match with Brock. Other than Seth, obviously. But he's had a fair few feuds already. Kofi has. And I'm not behind it myself. I'm all for a title being held by someone for about 2 months. But I believe after a couple of months, they need to relinquish, give somebody else a chance. It's not like the old days when I was a kid and you'd have somebody hold the title for like a year at a time. We don't need that these days. It gets a bit predictable. So you do need a change every couple of months, I believe. Especially with how many pay-per-views we get these days. What, like 3 a month, 4 a month or something? Sitting out about 3 a month, ain't it? So regular, these main event shows, that Kofi defending like 2 to 3 times a year, a month on a main event, on a pay-per-view, gets a bit predictable. He's going to win each time. Anyways, that's my thoughts on WWE right now, guys. What we're doing, a preview. What's the next one to come up? Is it SummerSlam? Is that the next main pay-per-view? We're only in July, there's got to be something before that. We'll see what it is, and maybe I'll do a preview or a review of that depending on how the show goes. Have a great day.